recommendation 92.3 of the Council of Europe is more clear in this respect, and it states that in the case of a severe genetic risk for all family members, consideration should be given to informing family members about matters relevant to their health or that of their future children. And recommendation 97.5 sets out that medical data may be communicated if such communication is a necessary measure in a democratic society for the protection of the rights and freedoms of others, or if the communication aims at the protection of the data subject for a relative in the genetic line. Thus, in conclusion, according to the different European legal texts and documents, we can say two things. Firstly, that health and genetic information is sensitive information that must be highly protected. And secondly, that there are exceptional situations that permit that information to be communicated to certain other people, even when this goes against the will of the data subject. Thank you very much.
Sergio, thank you very, very much for your presentation. And we come now to the next speaker. It is Eamon Daly, and he's talking about privacy of biometric information in a natural environment, a philosophical approach.
My name is Eamon Daly, I'm from New Zealand, and I'm down here because there's no ramp up to the stage, and we'll just leave it at that. I'm going to talk to you today about the privacy of biometric information in a networked environment using a philosophical approach. Next slide. This presentation covers the distinction between biometrics and biometric information systems, the development of personal privacy and information privacy from the perspective of two European philosophers, Immanuel Kant and John Stuart Mill. And also, I'll next move into some points on the privacy of biometric information, followed by an analysis of the privacy of biometric information from the point of view of Kant's categorical imperative. And I'll follow that with a summary and some concluding remarks. Biometrics is the automated measurement of human physical or behavioural characteristics with the intention of personal identification or authentication. Biometrics utilises a combination of digital computing and scanning technologies to capture data relevant to particular human, in this case, characteristics. Examples of biometrics include handwriting signatures, retina scans, fingerprints, voice prints, and DNA profiles. Biometrics operate by comparing a previously stored measurement with a new one, employing certain countermeasures to detect impersonation. Biometric information systems, on the other hand, are networked systems of biometric information utilize the inherent capabilities of information and communication technologies to greatly enhance the power and utility of biometrics. Networking technologies in particular are technologies of connection. They expand and combine over space and time the otherwise isolated technologies of biometric data capture and comparison. Biometric information in this networked environment is therefore subject to even greater privacy concerns. Over himself, over his own body and mind, the individual is sovereign. This is what John Stuart Mill said in 18th century England. For Mill, the private sphere is distinctly differentiable from the public. The boundary which separates the two is sharp and largely physical. One's liberty depends on a kind of ownership of one's thoughts, one's body, and one's personal space. These ideas emerged from the political tradition of liberalism and have had a major influence on the way privacy is conceived in modern Western societies. But personal privacy is different from information privacy. In this age of information, the limits of the personal are significantly changed. To adjust for this, in modern Western societies, the tendency has been to attempt to extend these million-derived ideas. Thus, information privacy becomes a matter of private property, separate from the public sphere. I believe this view provides a poor basis for understanding information privacy. Personal privacy is a first-order issue, whereas information privacy is a second-order issue, and that it refers outside itself. Interference with information privacy amounts to interference with personal control and decision-making. Information privacy is therefore more appropriately conceived in terms of personal autonomy and rational agency. That's from the Western paradigm. Kant's moral philosophy is ideally suited to this kind of conception. Just a point on how privacy issues actually arise in travel-related biometric information. Biometric information scanned at one point in a travel path is communicated to some or all downward points, setting in process a whole raft of effects which entail a loss of information privacy. Travellers may often therefore inadvertently participate in reducing their own autonomy by submitting to biometric scans. Biometric information, once scanned and communicated, is able to circulate through the entire global network of information systems, compounding this loss of information privacy and autonomy. Now, an example, from 2009, UK resident flying from the UK to the US